Amen. Praise and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor, power and might, to be our God forever and ever. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to the people on earth. Hear these words of Scripture. Love one another, for love is of God, and whoever loves is born of God and knows God.
Spirit of God, search our hearts.
Let us in silence remember our need for God's forgiveness. Let us confess our sins to God. God of mercy, we have sinned against you and against others. We have sinned in what we have done and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for our sins, forgive us all that is past and raise us to newness of life. Amen. Almighty God, who pardons all who truly repent, forgive your sins, strengthen you by the Holy Spirit, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer.
Amen.
O come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us rejoice in the rock of our salvation.
We sing to you, O God, and bless your name.
And tell of your salvation from day to day.
We proclaim your glory to the nations,
your praise to the ends of the earth.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans, I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I know. If I do what I do not want, I agree the law is good, but in fact it is no longer that I do, but sin that dwells within me, for I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is my flesh. I can will that is right, but I cannot do, for I do not do good for what I want, but the evil I do not want what I do. Now if I do what I do not want is wrong, I that do it, but sin then dwells within me, so I find it to be enough that when I want to do that is good, evil lies at hand, for I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see my members of the law at war with the law of my mind. It kept me captive to the law of sin that dwelt in my members, with man rescue me from this body of death. Thank me to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear that the Spirit is saying in our church.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus said to the crowd, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and to anyone whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thank you.
Let us now together proclaim our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
The Lord bless you.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Make your ways known upon earth, O God.
Your saving power among all peoples.
Renew your church in holiness.
And help us to serve you with joy.
Guide the leaders of this and every nation,
that justice may prevail throughout the world.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten,
nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Make us instruments of your peace,
and let your glory be over all the earth.
I'm Thank you. Thank you for my parents, Edward H. and Mary E. Vincent. 78 years together this day. Thank you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all.
Amen.
Go now to love and serve the Lord. Go in peace.
Amen.
Amen.
We go in the name of Christ.
Hallelujah!